他那个讲中文的时候像是在讲法文一样。
Hi, my name is John Flowers, and I'm from South Carolina.
我是从美国南卡州来的，我的名字叫 John Flowers。
Thank you for having me.
谢谢你们让我来。
It is an honor to be here with my brothers and sisters in Taiwan.
能够跟我在台湾的弟兄姊妹在一起，这是一个荣幸。
The favor of the Lord is here in Taiwan.
神的恩宠在台湾。
Amen.
Yeah. Amen. 我们一起来祷告。
Father, thank you for everything that you have done for the people of Taiwan.
天父，我们感谢你为台湾人所做的一切。
Thank you for the privilege of coming to receive love from our brothers and sisters.
感谢你给我这样的一个荣幸，能够来接受台湾弟兄姊妹对我的爱。
Holy Spirit, please come and illuminate your words.
圣灵，请你来到我们当中，来照明你的话语。
Lead us into all truth.
带领我们进入一切的真理。
Open our eyes and our ears to understand.
打开我们的眼睛，我们的耳朵，好叫我们能够明白。
Fill us with your love so that we can change the city.
让你的爱充满我们，好叫我们能够改变这个城市。
Thank you again for everything that you have done for us.
再次感谢你为我们所做的一切。
We trust you and we love you.
我们信靠你，我们爱你。
Amen.
Amen. Now, 我们一起来读马太福音第二十一章二十八到三十二节。马太福音第二十一章二十八到三十二节。又说一个人有两个儿子，他来对大儿子说，我儿，你今天到葡萄园里去做工。他回答说，我不去，以后自己懊悔就去了。又来对小儿子也说这样说，他回答说，父啊，我去，他却不去。你们想这两个儿子是哪一个遵行父命呢？他们说大儿子。耶稣说，我实在告诉你们，睡一个娼妓倒比你们先进神的国。因为约翰真的一路到你们这里来，你们却不信他；睡一个娼妓倒信他，你们看见了，后来还是不懊悔去信他。
A Chinese language is very beautiful.
中文很美。
I would like to share a little bit about myself so that you can get to know me.
我稍微自我介绍一下。
I grew up in a family with a very honored father in the church.
那我的父亲呢，在教会里面是非常受到尊重的。
He was very dutiful and was part of the leadership.
那他也是在教会里面的领袖之一。
Which meant there's a lot of pressure on me to do everything right.
就是说呢，在我在教会里面呢，就有很多的压力啊，必须要有好的表现。
I couldn't do everything right.
那我当然不可能每一件事情都做得好。
It's very hard when you're small to do everything that the big people do.
那在小的时候就要去做大人做的事情，事实上是很困难的。
So very early on, I learned a lot.
所以呢，很早我就学到怎么去撒谎。
It was a long time before I learned not to lie.
那我到后来才学会到怎么样不去说谎。
I would say just enough to get in enough trouble to feel bad, but not enough to quit doing what I was doing wrong.
然后呢，我被抓到的时候呢，就只会说一些话，让自己不会真正有麻烦但是还是继续做我原来做的。
I grew up in a family where Dad would spank us when we did something wrong.
那在我们家里面，如果我们犯错的话呢，父亲会打屁股的。
One time, and we don't remember.
那有一次呢，我不太记得。
One of my brothers or I ended up doing something wrong.
我跟我弟弟呢，不晓得哪一个人做错了。
And so dad lined us all up and said, who did it?
然后爸爸就让我们两个站在，让我们站在一起，然后说是谁做的？
Everyone said, not me, probably him.
每个人都说不是我，可能是旁边那个。
So we all got spanked.
所以我们后来每一个人都被打屁股了。
None of us have forgiven each other for that.
自从这个事情之后，我们彼此都不饶恕。
So I ended up going to university at a school called Clemson.
那后来我上的大学呢，叫做 Clemson。
And that was the first taste of freedom outside of my family.
那是我第一次在家外面能够尝到自由的滋味。
I had to learn how to make my own choices and become my own man.
我要学习怎么样去做自己的选择，成为一个这个自己要做的男人。
I was eager to figure out who was John Flowers.
所以我非常的迫切想要知道谁是花约翰，就是他自己。
And I was also wanting to prove that I was still a good Christian.
而且呢，我也希望能够证明我还是一个好基督徒。
Even though my parents weren't around, they were still with me in my head and heart.
虽然呢，在我父母亲的身上还是在我心里面，在我感觉上还是四面环绕。
So that made it even more difficult when I would make mistakes.
所以当我犯错的时候呢，就更加的困难了。
I had built a habit of lying to people instead of telling the truth.
所以呢，我就有习惯去说谎，而不是说实话。
And allowed darkness to grow in my heart, hidden.
就让黑暗呢，在我的心里面。
And I didn't know how to honor the legacy of my parents.
我就不知道怎么样去尊荣我父母亲他们的精神的遗产。
So in 2011, I got married.
后来2011年我结婚了。
And before that, I had begun to work through honesty with my wife.
在那个之前啊，我就跟我太太呢，就是要解决我这个说谎的问题。
Well, what kind of a person are you? Do you have a pure heart?
那就是看我们是不是有一个纯洁的心。
And I thought that everything was going to be okay.
我以为呢都不会有问题的。
I didn't realize how bad my problem was.
我并不意识到我的问题有多严重。
But I ended up turning down an invitation to a wedding.
后来呢我就拒绝这个婚礼的邀请。
And my wife said, "Why are we not going?"
那我太太跟我说，为什么我们不去呢？
And I realized in that moment that I had lied to her about the person in the wedding that I used to have feelings for.
那我后来才就是感觉，我才意识到说，我并没有，我事实上跟我太太说谎，我并没有对这个这个新郎新娘的这个心是对的。
My wife called me out.
那我太太呢，就把我逮个正着。
In what was one of the hardest and best moments of my life.
那对我来讲，可以说是一个最困难的时刻。
I began to feel ashamed.
我开始感觉到非常的惭愧。
What would my father think?
我的父亲会怎么想
？I've been lying to my wife.
我也跟我的太太说谎。
And she knew it.
她也知道。
It was a very difficult time.
这是一个非常困难的时候。
And it turned out she had struggled with her dad lying to her as a child.
她在年轻的在小时候呢，她父亲也曾经跟她说过谎，使得她心里非常的难过。
I didn't realize I had been partnering with the devil to hurt my wife.
我不知道，其实呢，我事实上是跟魔鬼合作，一起的来伤害我的父亲，伤害我的妻子。
So the sting of the pain was more real for her.
使得这个刺更加的痛。
And it wasn't a big lie, and it wasn't anything dangerous.
这个不是什么一个大谎言，也不会有什么危险。
But I had become okay with lying in my heart.
但是呢，我渐渐就习惯了在心里面说谎。
So in the process of that,
像这样的一个过程。
I felt like the Lord wanted me to call my dad.
我感觉到神要我打电话给爸。
And confess my sin to him.
来向他承认我的罪。
I know he loves me.
我知道他爱我。
But I knew it would be very difficult because of the shame.
但是我知道这会很困难，因为这是一个很让人羞耻的。
And I felt like I was supposed to call her dad.
那我也感觉到说我应该打电话给她的父亲，我太太的父亲。
Because he had trusted me to love her.
因为他也相信我能够去爱他的女儿。
Eventually, I got up the courage and called both dads.
最后呢，我就鼓起勇气打给这两个父亲。
And instead of shame, they offered me forgiveness.
那他们并没有让我羞耻，反倒是宽恕了我。
I was able to build relationship with both dads.
我就能够跟两个父亲呢，真正的建立关系。
And slowly learn to walk forward in honesty.
然后开始慢慢的学习怎么样诚实的往前走。
I want to talk about the parable that we've just read.
我们一起来看看刚刚所读的这个比喻。
The first son is honest with his dad.
那第一个儿子呢，对父亲是很诚实的。
And says he doesn't want to go.
他说他不想去。
But eventually he does go.
但是最后还是去了。
The second son says the right thing.
那第二个儿子呢，说了对的话。
But his heart is not toward his father.
但是他的心呢，却是远离他的父亲。
And that was the life I lived.
我过去就是这样。
It's very easy to allow a very small lie to build into a big one.
让小的谎言很快的就越来越变成大的谎言。
And become calloused in your heart toward the Holy Spirit.
在心里面呢，对圣灵就好像产生了一个茧一样。
I want to be the obedient son.
我希望能够成为一个顺服的儿子。
I want all of us to be the obedient children.
我也希望我们每一个人都是顺服的孩子。
The first point is Jesus is looking for those who will do what he requires.
那第一点要跟大家讲的就是，耶稣在寻找那些愿意顺服的人。
It's not because he's a taskmaster.
不是因为他是一个就是指派命令的人
，or a very hard boss，
或者是一个非常严酷的老板。
But he wants to know our hearts.
但是他要的是知道我们的心如何。
The second point is Jesus cares about our obedience.
第二点呢，就是耶稣在意我们的顺服。
Even if it takes longer than we expect.
即使呢，这个需要的时间是超过我们所期待的。
It took me a long time to be honest with my father.
我花了很长的时间才对我的父亲诚实。
But his heart was very soft toward me when I was courageous enough.
当我鼓起勇气的时候，向他坦诚，他对我非常的柔软。
And that's how our Father in heaven is.
事实上，我们在天上的父亲也是这样。
If you have not been honest with people,
如果你不能够对人诚实。
If you have not been honest with your Father in heaven,
如果你不能够对你在天上的父亲诚实。
Now is the time to be obedient.
现在是可以顺服的时候。
If he can't trust you to be honest with him.
如果他不能够信任你对他诚实的话，
How can he trust you to love someone else?
他怎么样能够信任你去爱另外一个人呢？
Saying the right thing and doing the right thing is different to God.
说对的话，做对的事情，对神事实上是不一样的。
Do you know the story of David being anointed?
大家记不记得大卫被膏做王的事情吗？
Samuel comes to the house of Jesse.
撒母耳呢就到了耶西的家里。
And he sees all the sons lined up.
他看到这些儿子们都排好了。
The first son comes forward.
第一个儿子出现。
And he looked exactly right.
撒母耳觉得，这个老大一定就是对的。
He was tall like Jonathan.
他就跟Jonathan 一样高。
And he looked really good like Clay.
他看起来非常的俊美，像 Clay 一样。
But he was not the right man.
但是呢，他不是对这个对的。
And Samuel went down the line of all the sons.
那撒母耳呢，就在这个儿子呢，一个一个看下去。
And every one of them was wrong.
没有一个是对的。
The Lord told Samuel, "Man looks at the outward appearance, but He looks at the heart."
神就跟撒母耳讲说，人都是看外表，神是看内心。
How you present yourself can be important.
你怎么样去表现自己也是重要。
But of greater importance is your heart.
但是更重要的是你的心。
That's what God really cares about.
这是神真正在意的。
Like any good father,
就像任何一个好的父亲一样。
When I told my dad I liked him,
那我跟我的父亲说我是对他撒谎。
He didn't care that I liked him.
他并不是很在乎我跟他撒谎。
He just wanted me to love my wife well.
他只是希望我能够好好的爱我的妻子。
Because that's a matter of the heart.
因为这是心的问题。
And he knew he could be proud of the son who loved his wife well.
他知道，当他儿子能够爱他的妻子的时候，就是他能够以他为荣的时候。
Samuel looked at all the sons who were wrong.
撒母耳看到这个大卫的这些哥哥们。
And he could have said, "All right, God was wrong."
他可以说，当初神要我来你们家，这是一个错误。
I must have misheard.
那我可能是听错了。
But instead, he said, "God is right."
但是呢，他却说神是对的。
There must be another son.
一定还有一个儿子。
And there was.
真的还有。
When we obey the Lord,
我们是不是愿意但当我们顺服神的时候
，He asks for full obedience.
他要的是一个完全的顺服。
He wants us to trust him fully.
他要我们完全的信靠他。
Even if we don't see what the result will be.
即使呢，我们还看不到结果是什么。
Aren't you thankful that he was obedient?
你是不是感恩他是顺服的呢
？From the royal line of King David.
从大卫的这个皇族的体系里面。
Our Savior Jesus was born.
这耶稣就诞生了。
Yeah. Amen.
Okay.
Let's read the second passage.
我们来看第二的经文，就是在路加福音第十五章十一到三十二节。耶稣又说，一个人有两个儿子，小儿子对父亲说：“父亲，请你把我应得的家业分给我。”他父亲就把产业分给他们。过了不多几日，小儿子就把他一切所有的都收拾起来。往远方去了，在那里任意放荡，浪费资财，既耗尽了一切所有的，又遇着那地方大遭饥荒，就穷苦起来。于是去投靠那地方的一个人，那人打发他到田里去放猪，他恨不得拿出所吃的豆荚充饥，也没有人给他。他醒悟过来，就说：“我父亲有多少谷工，口粮有余，我倒在这里饿死吗？我要起来到我父亲那里去，向他说：父亲，我得罪了天，又得罪了你。从今以后，我不配称为你的儿子，把我当作一个仆工吧。”于是起来到他父亲那里去，心相离还远。他父亲看见，就动了慈心，跑去抱着他的颈项，连连与他亲嘴。儿子说：“父亲，我得罪了天，又得罪了你。从今以后，我不配称为你的儿子。”父亲却吩咐仆人说：“把那上好的袍子快拿出来给他穿，把戒指戴在他指头上，把鞋穿在他脚上，把那肥牛犊牵来宰了，我们可以吃喝快乐，因为我这个儿子是死而复活，失而又得的。”他们就快乐起来。那时大儿子正在田里，他回来离家不远，听见作乐跳舞的声音，便叫过一个仆人来问是什么事。仆人说：“你兄弟来了，你父亲因他得无 无灾无病的回来，把肥牛给宰了。大儿子却生气，不肯进去。他父亲就出来劝他，他对父亲说：“我服侍你这么多年，从来没有违背过你的命。你并没有给我一只山羊羔，叫我和你朋友一同快乐。但你这个儿子和娼妓吞进了你的产业，他一来了，你倒为他宰了肥牛犊。”父亲对他说：“儿啊，你常和我同在，我一切所有的都是你的。只是你这个兄弟是死而复活，失而又得的，所以我们理当欢喜快乐。”
Thank you. Are you familiar with this passage?
大家对这个经文熟悉吗？
Do you feel as if you relate to the younger brother or the older brother?
你觉得你比较像大儿子还是小儿子呢？
都像。
Both.
Me too.
我也是。
I think this story is very important.
这个故事非常的重要。
For several reasons.
有几个原因。
Not only does it show us the easy paths that we can fall into.
不仅让我们看到我们很容易就会掉在其中的道路。
More importantly, it shows us the Father we can be like.
更重要的就是让我们看到天父是怎么样。
There are two paths we can choose.
有两条道路我们可以选择。
One is the easy way out.
一个呢就是容易的。
Like the prodigal son.
就好像这个浪子。
He asked his father for the money.
他跟爸爸要钱。
Which was the same as wishing he had been dead.
这个好像就是说希望巴不得他父亲已经死了。
Sometimes we don't understand our fathers.
有时候我们并不明白我们的父亲。
We don't understand what they offer us.
我们不明白他所要给我们的。
We feel it's easier to run away.
我们想说逃掉是比较容易的。
And pretend that he doesn't exist.
假设他并不存在。
Sometimes like the older brother.
有时候呢就像这个哥哥。
It's very easy to begin doing everything you can.
就是所有的事情尽量去做。
To try and earn the love of your father.
想要去赚得父亲的爱。
Both of those are wrong.
但是这两个其实都错。
We can't earn the love of our father.
我们没有办法去赚得爸爸的爱。
I have a little girl named Maddie Joy.
我的一个女儿叫做 Maddie Joy.
She's very cute.
非常的可爱。
Oh! I miss her.
Oh, 我好想她哦。
She's very small.
她很小。
And I love her much.
但是我对她的爱是大得不得了。
She can't earn my love.
她没有办法赚得我的爱。
I give it to her freely.
我是白白的给她。
Because she's mine.
因为她是我的。
She's part of me.
她是我的一部分。
I help make her.
因为我帮助她来到这世上。
She looks a little bit like me.
她看起来有点像我。
In fact, she's made in my image.
事实上呢，她是照着我的形象造的。
I can't help but love her.
我没有办法不去爱她。
I would do anything for her.
我什么事都可以为她做。
And that's exactly what our Father in heaven did.
我们在天上的父亲也是这样子做。
Amen.
Amen.
So the younger brother goes off and squanders the wealth.
所以这个弟弟呢，就出去浪费这些钱了。
I had a small season like that in college.
我在大学的时候有一段时间呢，也是这样。
I thought I was free and I could do what I wanted.
我想说我自由了，我什么都可以做了。
I did poorly in school.
在学校的成绩就很烂。
I lost my scholarships.
我就没有了奖学金了。
And I was afraid my parents would ask me to come home.
我那时候很害怕，我父母亲会要我回家。
And I had times when I was like the older brother.
那有时候呢，我就像这个哥哥。
I would be faithful and serve my dad at the church every week.
我在教会里面每个礼拜会去服侍。
I thought if I did all the things he did, he would like me.
我想说，我只要做了他所做的事情，那他还会喜欢我。
I was wrong.
我错了。
Turned out he liked me anyway.
后来我才知道，无论如何他都会喜欢我。
There's something about a childhood special to a father.
孩子们对父亲的有一个非常特别的点。
How many of you have children?
有孩子的请举手好吗
？Yeah. Wonderful. What a blessing.
多么大的祝福。
How many of you want children?
希望有孩子请举手好吗
Excellent. May the Lord bless you with as many children as you can handle.
所祝福主给你们孩子够多是你们可以这个照顾。
We need to learn to understand the heart of the Father.
我们需要学习明白天父的心。
And let me explain why.
我来解释为什么。
The Father treats each son differently.
父亲呢对每个孩子都不一样。
According to who that son is.
根据这个孩子的特质。
But his heart toward them is the same.
但是对他们的心呢却是一样。
He's a big enough Father to love each of us differently.
他是足够大的伟大的父亲，他能够对每一个人一样的爱，但是不同的方法。
In just the ways that we need.
能够照我们所需要的方式来对待我们。
The heart of the Father smiles at you.
这个父亲的心呢，总是对着你微笑。
It's an invitation to friendship.
这是一个邀请你做他朋友的。
The disobedient son comes home.
那不顺服的儿子回到家。
And believes he has to earn a place in his father's house.
他想说要努力才能够赚得在他父亲家里面的位置。
He is filled with sadness and shame.
他心里面充满的是悲伤跟羞耻。
But the father doesn't let him express it.
但是呢，天父却不让他，他的父亲不让他表现出来。
Sadness and shame have no place in the house of the Lord.
因为在神的家里面，没有这个地，没有地方是给羞耻还有悲伤的。
Instead, the father offers him gifts.
事实上呢，这个父亲就给他礼物。
He offers him the robe.
给他穿上袍子。
The ring.
给他戒指
and the sandals.
还有让他穿上鞋子。
The robe represents his identity.
这个袍子呢，就代表他的身份。
The family colors.
这个就是他家庭的颜色。
As he wears the robe, everyone will know who his father is.
当他穿上这个衣服袍子的时候呢，每一个人都知道他的父亲是谁。
And the honor that is on the father.
在这个父亲身上的尊荣。
Covers the shame of the son.
就遮盖了这个儿子的羞耻。
The ring represents the authority.
那这个戒指呢，代表的就是权柄。
It would have been a signet ring to seal documents.
这个戒指呢，事实上还能够当印章来用。
Showing that the full force of the father's power.
那这个就是代表了这个父亲的权柄。
Is entrusted to the son.
也传给了这个孩子。
The sandals represent purity.
这个鞋子代表的就是纯洁。
The father was saying your past doesn't alter who you are.
这父亲这个举动就在宣告说你的过去并不能够改变你的身份。
That where you have walked will not soil your future.
你过去所走过的路不能够玷污你的未来。
And how you walk will be different from now on.
从现在开始。你要怎么样去行走就不一样。
How kind is that father?
这个父亲是多么样的恩慈啊。
That's what our Father in heaven offers us.
在天上的父亲就是给我们同样的。
The second son,
第二个儿子
has been working hard in the field.
这大儿子呢在田里面工作努力。
When I was 6 years old, I began cutting the grass at my church.
我在6岁的时候呢，就帮忙教堂在割草。
That was my field.
那个就是我所雇的。
I wasn't big enough to really push the lawnmower.
我那个时候还不够大来推这个割草机。
So my older brother would push the top bar, and I would push the lower bar.
所以我的哥哥呢就会推上面的那个把手把，然后我就推比较低的那个把。
Together we could finally push it.
然后我们两个呢就可以一起来推动这个割草机。
For 8 years, we cut the grass at that church.
所以有8年的时间，我们一起来割教堂的草。
Every Saturday.
每一个礼拜六。
That did not earn love from my father.
但是呢，我们不能够用这个来赚得父亲的爱。
I didn't realize.
我那时候并不知道。
It was an invitation to be with him.
而是也是让我们跟他在一起的邀请。
To understand his heart.
来了解他的心。
Why did he serve the church?
为什么他要来服侍教会呢？
What did that mean for my mother?
这个对我母亲又有什么意义呢？
Later I found out he cut the grass of the church.
后来我就知道他割这个教堂的草。
So my mom could have 2 hours to rest.
这样我的妈妈能够有两个小时在家里自己休息。
There are 4 children in my family.
在我们家里面有四个孩子。
And we were wild.
我们都非常野啊。
She needed to rest.
所以她需要休息一下。
I didn't know why that's why we would go cut the grass.
我那时候并不知道为什么我们要去割草。
I thought that was part of being a Christian.
我以为说做基督徒就是要这么做。
Good works are good.
这个好行为是好的。
What God wants us to know is hard.
但是神更希望我们能够知道他的心。
The older brother stays in the field when the younger brother comes home.
当这个小儿子回来的时候，哥哥呢还在田里面工作。
And he gets mad when he hears the party.
当他听到在家里面的宴席的时候呢，哥哥心里不高兴。
He thought he was earning a party with his brother.
他以为说呢，宴席是为了他。
When my older brother left high school,
当我的哥哥他离开高中的时候
，he began his own path.
他开始走自己的道路。
And he made mistakes.
他犯错。
And it was very hard on our family.
对我们全家来讲是非常困难。
When he came home,
当他回家
，from Eastern Europe,
从东欧回来
，he was mad at the family.
他对家人生气
，But father welcomed him home.
但是父亲欢迎他回来。
He was poor.
他没钱。
But dad gave him all the money he needed.
但是神把他需要的钱都给了他。
Even though he didn't have the money.
即使父亲其实自己也没什么钱。
And I began to resent my brother.
我开始呢就厌恶我的哥哥。
I had done what he did.
我并没有做他所犯的错。
I had been good.
我是很好的。
Why wasn't Dad paying my bills?
为什么这个神没不我的爸爸没有付我的账单
？Then I realized.
然后我才了解。
I was being the older brother in the story.
我就像是这个故事里面的大儿子一样。
Why would I not want my brother to receive the love of my dad?
我为什么不让我的哥哥领受我爸爸的爱呢？
Had I done everything perfectly?
我自己有没有做得很完美呢？
And was my dad not kind to me?
那我爸爸会因为我犯错就不对我好吗？
Have any of you had that experience?
你们是不是有曾经有这样的经验呢？
Yeah.It turns out the father wanted the older brother.
后来呢，这个我们看到这个爸爸呢要大儿子
to be with him at the party,
能够一起来参加宴席。
He wanted him to know his heart.
他希望儿子能够知道他的心。
But the older brother was confused.
但是大儿子呢确实很困惑。
He just wanted things.
他只是希望物质。
Money,
钱
feasts,
宴席
and applause from his father,
从他父亲来的鼓掌
But the father wanted to be his friend.
但是他的父亲希望能够做他的朋友
to share the joy together,
让他们一同的来分享喜乐
When we understand how kind and good our father is,
当我们知道我们的父亲有多好的时候。
It's easier to celebrate.
我们就很容易的能够欢庆。
Whether you are the younger brother or the older brother.
不管你是这个大儿子或小儿子。
We are all called to be friends of God.
我们都蒙召要成为天父的朋友。
First point was the older brother didn't understand the father was looking for relationship and not slavery.
所以第二点，第一点呢，我们看到大儿子不明白天父。期待与我们建立的关系不是奴隶关系。
John 15:15，
约翰福音第15:15，之后我们再称你们为仆人，因仆人不知道主人所做的事，我乃称你们为朋友，因我从我父所听见的，已经都告诉你们了。
Jesus is in the upper room with his disciples.
耶稣在最后晚餐跟他的门徒在一起。
And he wants them to know that their relationship is changing.
他要让门徒们知道他们的关系到了一个新的阶段。
Jesus was going to begin telling them the secrets of his heart.
耶稣要告诉他们他心中的一个秘密。
Out of friendship.
是从因为他们的友谊。
It is only in friendship.
只有在友谊当中。
That we can begin to carry the authority of Christ.
我们才能够有耶稣的权柄。
Because the authority of Christ requires love.
因为耶稣的权柄呢，是因为爱。
Jesus was the perfect representation of his Father.
耶稣呢，是天父一个完美的代表。
And that's where we're headed.
我们也朝着同样的方向。
We are being shaped into the image of Christ.
我们被摩塑成为耶稣的形象。
So that we can be his friend.
好像我们也能够成为天父的朋友。
And carry his authority into the world.
能够把他的权柄带到这世上。
Do you want to carry the authority of Christ into the world?
你希不希望能够把基督的权柄带到这个世界上呢？
Do you want to be a friend of Jesus?
你希不希望能够作为耶稣的朋友呢？
Then you must put aside the ways of the prodigal son.
那你就必须要把这个浪子的这些方式把它丢弃掉。
And embrace the Father.
来拥抱天父。
To put away the ways of the older brother.
把这个哥哥的这种方式也放弃掉。
And embrace the Father.
来拥抱父亲的。
He's offering everything you need.
他给你你所需要的一切。
2 Corinthians 5:16-21.
在哥林多后书。哥林多后书第五章16-21节。哥林多后书第五章16-21节。我们从今以后不凭着外貌认人了，虽然凭着外貌认过基督，如今却不再这样认他了。若人在基督里，他就是新造的人，旧事已过，都变成新的了。一切都是出于神，借着基督我们与他和好，又将圣灵他和好的职分赐给我们。这就是神在基督里叫世人与自己和好，不将他们的过犯归到他们身上。并且将这和好的道理托付了我们，所以我们做基督的使者，就好像神借着我们劝你们一般。我们替基督求你们与神和好，神使那无罪的替我们成为罪，好叫我们在他里面成为神的义。
The father in the story，
在这个比喻里面的父亲
，is our example of the ministry of reconciliation。
这是一个。我们使人和好的职分的一个很好的例子。
Sometimes we cover those in shame.
有时候呢，我们会用我们会把这个羞耻遮盖。
Sometimes we go and find those who are too busy working.
有时候呢，我们就是找到一些好像太忙的人。
Either way, our job.
但是不管怎么样，我们的工作。
Is to connect people to the heart of our heavenly Father.
就是要让人的心能够跟天父的心连接。
We are ambassadors of the kingdom of Christ.
我们都是基督国度的使者。
Jesus died to give us a robe, a ring, and sandals.
耶稣为我们死，好叫我们能够穿上他的袍子，戴上他的戒指，也穿上他的鞋子。
So that we can go and find the prodigals and the older brothers.
让我们能够去寻找那些浪子以及大儿子。
How would you like to see the city of Taipei full of sons?
你是不是希望能够看到台北充满了这个神的孩子呢？
And daughters that know the heart of the Father.
让他们能够知道天父的心是怎么样的。
People who understand friendship with God.
当一个人能够明白与神的友谊的时候
，Close your eyes and picture with me。
请大家把眼睛闭起来，我们一起来想象一个图画。
What would it look like if the city of Taipei was full of the love of Christ?
如果台北充满了基督的爱，会是怎么样子呢？
What is your place in that?
那你现在是在什么样的位置上呢？
What would it look like if Christ's love were in your work?
那如果基督的爱在你的这个工作的地方，会是怎么样的？
What would it look like if His love were in your home?
如果基督的爱在你的家里面的话，会是怎么样的？
What would it look like if your family all came to know Jesus?
如果你的家人都认识基督的话，那会是怎么样的？
You are the ambassador.
你就是基督的使者。
You carry the kingdom of God.
你带着神的国度。
You get to partner with the Most High.
你与至高者同工。
To see your city change.
能够看到你的城市改变。
Thank you.
谢谢。
I have some questions for you. Can I do this? Okay. I'm practicing hearing the voice of the Lord.
我也在操练聆听神的声音。
In John chapter 10, it says the sheep know the voice of the shepherd.
约翰福音第十章里面讲到说，羊能够听到主人的声音。
So I feel like the Lord has given me some encouragement for some of you.
我感觉到神给我一些话语，要来鼓励我们当中的一些人。
If I get it wrong, forgive me.
如果我听错了，请你原谅我。
I'm not perfect.
我也不是完美的。
Is there someone here named Chris?
我们当中是不是有一个人叫 Chris?
No, sorry. You're right. Yeah, I meant Chris. Sorry, I was on the wrong page. Yes, Chris. The Lord gave me a word for you.
神给我一些话给你。
You have the heart of a tiger.
你的心呢，就像老虎一样。
I saw a picture of you slicing a loaf of bread.
那我看到一个图画，就是你在这个切面包。
The Lord wants to honor your faithfulness.
神要来尊荣你的忠心。
Thank you.
谢谢。
Your faithfulness will be rewarded.
你的忠心呢，会得到奖赏。
What's your name?
Paul.
Paul?
刘静。
That's my brother's name.
刚好是他那个兄弟的名字。
I feel like the Lord wants to give you favor at work.
我感到神让你在工作会得到恩宠。
Favor in your studies.
还有你的读书。
I saw a picture of a duck going down the river.
我看到有一个鸭子呢，在河流往下游。
It's a peaceful journey.
这是一个非常平安的旅程。
I feel like the Lord wants to give you good sleep at night.
我感觉到神要让你晚上能够睡得好。
Have you had nightmares?
你最近有一些噩梦吗？
Okay, good. I'm practicing.
我只是在操练。
Does the date February 12 mean anything to anyone?
我们当中没有人对二月十二号有什么特别的这个事情在你的生命当中。二月十二号有谁在二月十号有没有谁对二月十二号对谁有特别意义的一个
birthday or anniversary？
比如说生日啦，或者是结婚周年啦。
No?
没有啊。
Okay.Does someone own a red scooter and a yellow helmet?
有没有人呢是骑这个红色的摩托车，戴黄色的这个安全帽
？Yellow.
Yellow helmet.
有没有红色摩托车，然后戴黄色的头盔的那个安全帽？有没有
？Okay, I'm practicing.
我是超级超级 ，Maybe English service.
I know, yeah, I'm saying English service. It's not here. Is there someone named Andrew?
我们当中有没有人名字叫 Andrew 的 ？Andrew.
There's actually English services happening.
Oh, there is. Oh, the Lord spoke to me early.
是你那是在英文堂的，那个神是太早跟我讲了。
Does someone have pain in their right shoulder?
有没有人在右肩膀疼痛的？
No,
右肩关节
is it no more tingling?
像这是一直有一种刺痛的感觉的。
Oh, good. I mean, no. I got one. I'd like to pray for you you stand up?
你站起来，我为你祷告。
I'm going to pray for you.
为你祷告。
Will you put your hand on her shoulder?
请为姊妹按手在她的右肩关节。
And extend your hand, please extend your hands toward her.
大家伸出你的手，对着她来祷告。
What is her name?
叫
Cindy.
Cindy?
Yes.
Awesome. Yeah. Father, thank you for Cindy. Thank you for blessing her in every way.
感谢为她感谢主，感谢你祝福她在各方面。
Thank you for highlighting her today.
谢谢你今天把她点出来。
So that she knows you see her.
让她知道你看到她。
Thank you for loving her.
谢谢你爱她。
I see you heal her shoulder right now.
我看到你现在就医治她的肩膀。
Pain go away in Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名，疼痛离开。
Amen.
May the love of Christ rule in your heart and your mind.
让主的爱充满你的心，充满你的思想。
I see a picture of you working with your hands.
我看到你用手在做工作。
Creative.
你很有创意。
Knitting.
好像是在那个打毛线。
Yeah, I feel like the Lord wants to bless you.
我感觉到神要来祝福你。
In the work to which you put your hands.
在你所做的事情上面都要来祝福你。
Thank you, Jesus.
感谢耶稣。
Amen.
Amen.